Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. In this video, you will be watching a live demo of Ace. It's an advanced white label online marketplace builder solution. So do watch this video till the end. By online marketplace builder, I mean that you can run, manage and grow different businesses from a single place. From on-demand delivery to taxi booking, handyman, home service booking, to renting, listing product, you can manage everything from this one-stop marketplace solution. Want to check more? Just check out the link in the description below. To start with, let me tell you that it's a white label online marketplace builder solution that includes branded ordering website and mobile apps for customers, easy to use app for delivery agents or the service providers, advanced admin panel where being the business admin, you can control everything that happens on the marketplace. Vendor panel for the registered vendors. So let's begin with the demo. So let's start with the live demo of the website of this marketplace solution. So at the extreme left, you can see Ace. This is the logo of this marketplace. If you buy the white label solution, you can get your own branded logo over here. So at the side of the logo, you can see different options of delivery, booking, takeaway. Under delivery would be the service providers that are offering delivery services. Under booking, you can simply book a taxi or book handyman or home services that are being offered on the platform. And similarly, under takeaway, you can shop for food and grocery items from the stores that are offering takeaway services only. Below that, you can see restaurant, supermarket, pharmacy. So if you want to order for food, you can simply go to the restaurant category. If you want to order for groceries, you can choose supermarket. Similarly, you can add new categories like taxi booking, home services, etc. from the admin panel. So as a customer, if you want to order or book for any service, you can do it from here itself. So from here, you can change the language of the website. From the currency section, you can set your primary currency and you can switch to the control panel from the My Account section, manage your profile. So let's move forward. So you can see these are the floating banners. So the banners also serve as an additional source of revenue. I would explain about the banners at the admin panel in detail. Below that, you can see all the registered outlets that are offering their products or services on the platform. Under outlets are the featured products, the newly added products, the on-sale products, the best-selling products. So, and below that, you can see the top brands that are offering their services. From the pickup and delivery option, you can either book a taxi or you can hire movers and packers to any location you want to go to. And from the quick links, you can view the privacy policy of this application. You can view the terms and conditions. And if you want to register as a vendor or service provider, in other words, if you want to offer any services on this platform, you have to click on the vendor registration button. So moving to the vendor registration process. So to register as a vendor, you would have to upload the personal details such as your name, your phone number, your title, your email ID. And likewise, you will have to upload the store logo, your banner, the name you want to display on this marketplace, description of services that you're providing, and whether you would be providing booking, takeaway or delivery services. And after filling in the attributes, you will have to click on submit and the request would be sent to the admins in the admin panel. So moving back to the home of this website. So if you want to order for any product or any services, you can do it from here and the booking request would be sent to the admin. Now let me show you quickly how to book any product. Suppose if I want to order for this food, so I can select the quantity as a customer, what quantity I want. I can select the variant, whether I want it full or half. Now if as a customer I don't want this to order for now, I can add this to my wish list so that it could remind me later that a product is in my wish list and then I can order it anytime later. If I want to order it now, I can simply click on add to cart. So you can see the product has moved to the cart. Also, as a customer, you can view the description and rating and reviews for any particular item or product that is being sold on this platform. Now let's move on to the cart section. Now you can see this is a takeaway address. So this product is only for takeaway. This is the delivery fee, the subtotal, if I want to give a tip to the delivery agent, I can select it from here. So this is the total amount that is to be payable. So as I already told that it's a takeaway order, so I can order it for now or schedule it for any time later. If I choose to schedule it, I would have to select the time or my desired date for which I want the order to be delivered at. So let's click on select now and click on paste order. So you can select from different payment options. So let's choose cash on delivery for now. So you can see the booking request has been sent to the admin. So let's move on to the admin panel of this marketplace. So from my account, you just have to go to the control panel. So this is the admin panel, where being the business owner, you can manage everything that happens either on the customer application or the delivery agent application or the website. So this is the dashboard where you can see the pending orders, active orders, number of orders delivered, cancelled by the customers, total number of vendors or service providers registered, number of service categories being offered, total number of products, total number of banners being run on the platform, number of brands that have registered, number of return requests initiated by the customers. So below that you can see the sales analytics. So you can keep a track of how your business is performing on yearly, weekly and monthly basis. And also you can download this report in different formats. So you can track your revenue and monthly or weekly sales from this sales analytics tool. Below that you can see the revenue by location. So if you are offering your services in different locations, so you can keep a track on what particular, from what particular location you are getting the most number of orders and revenue from. At the side you can see orders or which particular product or service you are getting the higher number of orders from. So let's move on to the order section. So pending orders. So you can see this is the order I have placed from the website. Being an admin, I can either accept or reject the order. If I click on accept, now this will move to the active order section. So you can see this order has been removed from the pending order section and it has moved to the active order section. So being an admin, you can manage the pending orders, active orders, and also you can check the entire order history of all the orders that are delivered, cancelled. You can view the order history for any particular time interval or for any particular vendor. You can see the total number of return requests in the return request section. And if you want to search for any specific order, you can do that by entering the order ID in the search bar. Now let's move to the outlets. Outlets are the total number of service providers who are offering different services on this platform. So being an admin, you can view the outlet name, what type of services are they offering, what is the commission percentage that they are paying, total number of products they are offering, total number of orders they have got, how many active orders do they currently have. So you can edit any existing outlet. So you can upload the logo, banner, name, description, email ID, website, assign any more categories to that particular outlet and click on submit. In order to add a new outlet or vendor, you just have to click on the add button, and similarly you can fill in all the attributes. If you want to edit the action of any particular outlet that is currently live on the platform, you can do that as well. So you can manage the catalog, configuration, categories and add-ons for this particular outlet. So you can see this is the configuration. So I can set whether this outlet can automatically accept order or not. And if it doesn't accept order in a particular time, that order would automatically get rejected. So this is the catalog or the services being provided by this registered vendor. I can add any new services by clicking on the add product button. This is the commission percentage. This is the category setup. So being an admin, I can also assign different vendors category. Suppose if this vendor wants to serve taxi services, so I can assign motor service, auto service. If he wants to start restaurant business, so I can enable this restaurant category. And likewise, the admin has the access to manage anything that cut. So being an admin, I have the access to assign as many categories and permissions to any particular vendor or service providers who's offering their services on this marketplace. Now let's come to the accounting section. Being an admin, you can manage the accounting details for different options like orders, loyalty cards, promo code, taxes, outlet, and payout request. So let's move to the accounting details for the orders. So here you can keep a track of all the accounts for different orders you have got till now. So this is the total revenue that you have generated for all the orders received. These are the total number of orders that have been successfully completed. This is the pending amount that has to be collected. This is the total delivery fees. Similarly for loyalty cards. Similarly, you can manage the accounting details for loyalty cards, promo code, accounting details for the taxes being charged, accounting details for the outlets or the vendors. And similarly, you can manage the accounting details for the payout request generated by different vendors. And being an admin, you can either approve or reject the payout request. That's totally up to you. It's worth noticing that these accounting details are easy to access and are easily downloadable in different formats for any particular time interval. So now let's move to the subscriptions section, where you can manage subscription plans for both the customers as well as the vendors. So these are the user subscription plans. So there are 4 ready-made subscription plans that a customer can purchase from the customer application: gold plan, silver plan, bronze plan, platinum plan. These are the pricing details. These are the features or the facilities customers get while purchasing these subscription plans. This is the frequency. So admin can enable or disable any subscription plan from the application. Also, you can add any new subscription plan by clicking on the add plan button. Now you can upload the image of the plan, enter the title, price or pricing, set the frequency, enter the description and click on submit. Similarly, you can manage subscriptions for different vendors. Now let's move forward to the customer section, where as an admin, you can manage the complete data of all the customers that have registered on the customer application. So you can view their name, their login type, their email, phone number, OTP, their current wallet balance, any loyalty points they have, number of active orders. So you can manage the customer profile by clicking on the action button. If you want to make a customer a vendor, you can do that from the customer section itself. So you can see this is the customer. You can choose whether to provide him the admin access or not. If not, you can assign him different categories like access to the admin dashboard, the order section, the vendor section. Similarly, he can manage taxes, loyalty cards, load banners himself or not. Similarly, you can assign different vendors who would be offering their services under that particular vendor. From the products review section, you can view the ratings and reviews given by the customers to different vendors or service providers. From the profile section, you can manage your profile, like upload the logo. You can see this is the short code that would connect this marketplace to the dispatch panel. You can update the name, email ID, contact number, set the company address. From the customize section, you can choose between the light and the dark theme for the platform, view and update the date and time format of the marketplace. Define and update the localization, like set the primary language, primary currency, add any additional languages and currencies, set the custom domain, interlink any social media accounts, or set the nomenclature of this marketplace. From the styling, you can manage the app styling or web styling, let me show it to you. Like from the web styling, you can manage the homepage style. You can upload the five icons, set the primary color, top header color, whether you want the age restriction pop-up to display or not. So you can also manage what all to be displayed on the website, like whether you want to show the wishlist icon or not, ratings, cart icon, contact us icon. So you have the access to display or hide anything that would be displayed on the website or the application. Now moving forward to the CMS, that is the content management system. So as admin, you can manage all the content that would be either displayed on different pages of the marketplace, like what content would you want to be displayed on the vendor registration page, what are the terms and conditions, privacy policy, likewise what content would be sent in a different emails, and similarly what all content would be sent in a different notification that are either sent to the admin or the vendor. That are similarly, you can set what content would be sent to the through different notifications being sent to the customers or the vendors. From the catalog, you can manage different categories, variants and brands. So under categories, you can see different products and services that are being offered by different vendors that have registered on the marketplace. Similarly, you can add a variant to any particular category. And here you can see different brands who are offering their services. You can add a new brand by clicking on the add brand button. Similarly, you can fill in the attributes and that brand would be displayed on the website and the application. You can add a new category. Also, you can manage configurations, like whether a vendor would be offering hyperlocal services or would he be offering last mile delivery services, on-demand services or the pickup and delivery services. For last mile delivery and on-demand services and the pickup and delivery services, this platform would be interlinked with the dispatch panel. Now let's come to the taxes section, where you can manage the existing taxes or add any new tax category. And from the payment options, you can set what all payment options would you want to display on the website or the mobile application. Like you can enable or disable cash on delivery, PayPal, Stripe, PayStack, PayFast, etc. Also, if you want to integrate any additional payment gateway, that option is also available. For that, just reach out to us through the link in the description. Now let's come on to the most important part of this admin panel, where you can manage marketing. Now let's come to the most important part of this admin panel, from where you can access different marketing tools. Let's first come to the banners. So banners are the floating banners that are displayed on the both the web application and the mobile application. These also serve as an additional source for the admin, as they charge a commission fee from the vendors who have registered on the platform to display their banner. In return, you offer them greater visibility and ensure them higher number of orders, because the customers can find them easily. So in order to add a banner, you have to click on the add banner button. Now you can upload the banner image, set the banner validity and assign it to any category or vendor. Similarly, you can add banners for the mobile application. Moving to the promo codes. You can add new promo codes that would be sent, that would be available for the customers. If you want to add a new promo code, you will have to enter the title, short description for that promo code, what is the promo type, whether it is on the percentage basis or the fixed amount, the expiry date, what services would be available with that promo code, who would pay the promo code, the minimum amount, maximum amount, the limit per user, and likewise you can select your preferences. And in a similar way, you can manage the loyalty cards as well. So these are the existing loyalty plans and the minimum points that are required to achieve the same. So this is the basic flow of the admin panel of this advanced white label online marketplace builder solution. So from here you can see pickup and delivery dashboard. If you click on the same, you would be redirected to the dispatcher panel of this marketplace. You can check out the detailed demo video on the same. The link is given in the description. Also, you can check out the suggested video section above. So this is how the add-in panel of this marketplace solution works. Now I will quickly take you through the live demo of the mobile application. So let's now start with the live demo of the customer application of this online marketplace builder. So this is the home screen of the application, but first let's go to the account section where as a customer you can either sign up or log in. So let me show you the sign up process as a first time user. So you get multiple sign up options, like you can sign up using your Gmail account, your email, phone number or Apple ID. After signing in, you will be logged into the application. Starting with the home screen, you can see the floating banners. Below banners are different booking options like delivery, takeaway, etc. Next comes the service categories like delivery, cab service, motor service, etc. If you want to hire movers or packers or get a parcel delivered at your doorstep, you can enter the pickup drop-off location. Similarly, you can hire a cab or a taxi. Likewise, you can shop for e-commerce products, medicines, or book handyman home services. Next come different vendors. You can choose any vendor as per the service you require. Suppose as customer, I want to order food. So I'll select the food item and it will be added to my cart. So likewise, you can book a service with any vendors on the marketplace. Moving to the cart section, you can view order details, give any tip to the driver or delivery agent, select your payment mode. Also, you can select whether to place order now or schedule it for later. You can update the delivery address. And once done, your order request would be sent. So here you can see the order request is sent, but it's waiting for the admin approval. So let's head back to the admin panel. Here you can see this order is again in the pending order section. So let's confirm it. Now it is in the active order section where you can change the status of the order and the customer would get the live updates of the changes you make. Lastly, coming to the account section, you can manage your profile, change password or update your address. You can purchase subscription plans. You can view your loyalty points. From order history, you can view all the orders you have placed and what is their status. From settings, you can change the appearance. And most importantly, if you are registered as a vendor or a service provider, you can view the total orders you have got till now, how many are in cart, and the total revenue you have generated. So this is the customer application. So if you too are looking to launch your own online marketplace and willing to know more about this online marketplace builder solution, so just feel free to reach out to us through the link in description. Thanks.